to my YouTube channel. You were listening to one of the most popular classical guitar pieces, Cavatina. This beautiful piece was composed by Stanley Myers and has been used in a couple of movies. The Walking Stick back in the 1960s and the Deer Hunter movie in the 1980s. It is a piece for the advanced player, but all are certainly welcome to try their hand at it. These lessons are designed for those who can read music notation or tabs. I think that you'll find it easy to follow and enjoyable and rewarding to work through. Remember to practice often and slowly. I hope that you enjoy these lessons. Please subscribe to my channel and feel free to send any constructive suggestions or comments. So get your guitar and let's begin. Right, so let's start. What you will notice on the screen is the score for each measure. Right, if you don't read the proper notation, music notation, then below that we have the tabs where each line represents one of the six strings. Below that you will see a table with a couple of notes pertaining to that particular measure. So right, so the first measure we find that it's in the fourth fret position, which is 1, 2, 3, 4. We need a bar up to the fifth string. The chord is called E. So we find the notes. The 7 on the top on the first line indicates the 7th fret on the first string. The 0 indicates the open string. And then you can find the rest of the notes. 6th fret on the 4th string, 3rd fret, 4th fret on the 3rd string, and the 2nd, 5th fret on the 2nd string. And if you play in that sequence, it becomes... Let's have a look at measure 2. Now we need to move to the 6th. The 6th position, the bar at the 6th fret, once again up to the 5th string, and just find those notes, and this is what it sounds like. If I combine the two, it becomes... Measure 3, we need to move to the 9th position, and we have a bar once again, but this time we have a full bar at the 9th position or the 9th fret. Right, notice also that on the 2nd string we need to hammer the notes from the 10th fret to the 12th fret. Alright, find the notes, and it becomes this. Measure 4 is also the 9th position, also a bar, full bar. The chord shape remains the same, but we're now going to start on a different bass note, and this becomes the chord of F sharp minor 7th. If I combine the two, it becomes... We're at measure 5. To get your notes to sound smooth, or the term that we use in music is legato, it is important that you not play consecutive notes with the same right hand finger. You need to alternate your fingers. Using the same finger results in a staccato or a chopped sound. So the first example that we have of this in the piece is at measure 5, where, as you will see, we need to find a bar at 7, full bar at 7, And then your fourth finger is going to play the 10th fret note on the second string, which is an A. Anyway, so I want you to play that second string note with your index finger. And the sixth string, obviously, you're going to play with your thumb. Right? Then the next note you have to play, I want you to use your middle finger. And then the next one for the first string to use your ring finger or the A finger. Becomes. For measure 6, we still stand at the bar at 7. We now need to change our fingers and the notes we're playing. Also at measure 6, please notice that you will see the letter P. Appears quite a few times in the top score. The letter P stands for the right hand thumb. It's a Spanish word, pulga, which means thumb. So it indicates that those notes need to be played with your right hand thumb. A rule of thumb would be to reserve your right hand thumb for playing the fourth string, fifth string, and the sixth string. All right? That helps to balance your right hand. So to combine measure 5 and measure 6, it then becomes. Measure 7, we had the 7th position. There's no bar this time. The chord up that I'm playing is the E major 7th chord. So find those notes, and this is what it sounds like. Measure 8, we're at the 3rd position. The chord is E7. Find the notes, and it sounds like this. Notice that the last two notes, we are playing the A on the first string to the G sharp. We need to play the note, and then your finger pulls. So it's a pull-off. From the A to the G7th. Together, measure 7 and 8 sounds like this. Measure 9, we're at the 2nd position. We now have to play a half bar, or rather a bar up to the 4th string. Find those notes, and this is what it sounds like. Measure 10. Still at the 2nd position, still the same bar up to the 4th string, but now we add some notes. Measure 11 is the G major 7th chord at the 2nd position. Find the fingering, and it sounds like this. measure 12, C major 7th, also at the second position. These are the notes. Combined. We are at measure 13, still the second position. The chord is the B7 suspended fourth. And this is how it sounds. Measure 14. Still the second position, still the B7th chord. But now we're using the thumb differently. So pay attention to that. Measures 13 and 14. Measure 15 is in the first position, the E suspended fourth chord. Measure 16, the same chord continued. The last three notes is found at the ninth position. This is how it sounds. And 16 combined.